Hello, this is NanoDano at devdungeon.com, and this tutorial is going to walk through the process of installing the Java 1.8 and Java 9 JDKs in Windows for Java development. When we're done, we'll have both JDKs installed with one of them set up as our default, leaving us with a Java development environment ready to compile and run applications. For this example, we will install the Java 1.8 and Java 9 JDKs in that order to show how to manage two versions at once. Java 9 is the latest right now, but NetBeans and some other tools require Java 1.8 still. If you only want to install one version, I recommend using 1.8 for now. Find the installers by searching for Java 1.8 JDK and Java 9 JDK, or go directly to these links from oracle.com. Note that you can also find JDK 8 bundled with NetBeans from Oracle directly, if you want to install the IDE at the same time. I recommend NetBeans, so if you haven't yet picked an editor, you can't go wrong with NetBeans, it's a great choice. Make sure you download the JDK and not the JRE. The JRE is only the Java runtime environment, which is all you need as an end user to run the program, but doesn't include the compiler and other development tools. The JDK is the Java development kit and needed for compiling. The JDK also includes the JRE, so there's no need to download both the JDK and JRE separately. On the download page, accept the license by clicking the radio button and download the relevant version, Windows X64 for me. If you want to download demos and sample code, scroll down on the 1.8 page and download the demos that go with the JDK you chose. I highly recommend getting these. It's full of great code examples. You can use them as reference material, and there are some pre-compiled versions ready to run. The demos are not installed, but come in a zip file of standalone Java source code examples and jar files, so you can just download them and extract them and run them. After downloading the 1.8 JDK, download the Java 9 JDK in the same fashion. After downloading the installers, simply locate your downloaded files and double-click them to run the installer. I'm going to install 1.8 first, and then 9. You can go through both of the installers with all of the default settings, unless you want to change the installation path. The first version of Java installed will add itself to your path environment variable, which allows you to open the command prompt and start using Java and Java C on the prompt. It will also configure files with the jar extension to be runnable by double-clicking them. When you install the second version, it will override and take over as the default version of Java for the system. If we want to test the jar launcher, let's unzip the demo files for the Java 8 JDK. Inside the demos folder, go to Demos, Java FX Samples, and then double-click on the mandelbrot-set.jar. You could also hold Shift and right-click on the blank space in the folder in the Explorer and choose Open PowerShell Window here, and then execute java-jar mandelbrot-set.jar. After installing JDK 1.8 first, then I'm going to install JDK 9. This will leave Java 9 as the default system after installation. I'll want to set 1.8 as my default though, so after this we're going to show you how to update the path. To edit your environment variables, press the Windows key and search for Environment. The first result should be a result for editing environment variables. Click on that. Follow that and it should open your System Properties window. From here, the Environment Variables button is in the bottom right. From here, you can change your path variables. Note that there is a path for your system at the bottom and one for your user at the top. The installers should update your system path with the generic path to Java. You can delete that entry and modify it and point it at your preferred JDK bin directory. In my example, C:\program files/java /JDK1.8/bin. Once the environment variable is set, we can open a command prompt and type java-version to see what version is being used. We can also type where java and where java c to see exactly which executables are being called. If you want to write your own simple hello world just to get started, then pop open the notepad and write this out. Create a class called hi, add a public static void main, and have it system_out.println hello world. I'll just save it to the desktop as hi.java. Remember, the class name needs to match the file name. Then I'll hold shift and right click on the desktop and choose open PowerShell window here. Then I'm going to run javac hi.java. Then you can run the compiled class using java hi. The output should say hello world. And congratulations, you have a basic Java development environment ready to go. That's all we're going to cover in this video, but your next step should be choosing a text editor or an IDE. I would not recommend anyone actually use Notepad for Java development though, because it doesn't even have basic syntax highlighting. NetBeans, IntelliJ, IDEA, and Eclipse are all viable options, but you can also choose something like Visual Studio Code, Atom, Sublime Text, or even Vim. While I really like the JetBrains IntelliJ IDE, the next tutorials I'm going to cover the installation and configuration of NetBeans, and then introduce the NetBeans Rich Client platform, which allows you to make advanced GUI applications using the NetBeans platform. By learning about the NetBeans Rich Client platform, or RCP, you'll learn how to create plugins and modify NetBeans IDE itself to provide a better experience or to support custom tools or languages. Not only can you use it to extend NetBeans itself, but you can use the NetBeans platform to create custom applications that are not even IDEs necessarily. If you have any Java installation tips for beginners, help out the community and leave a comment. Thanks for watching. Check out devdungeon.com and subscribe to the channel.